In this video, we will give you a small introduction of the X-Carb CNC, X1 Carb CNC. So, first of all, let me tell you that this entire axis is called as the X-axis for the router. Right? It moves from left to right in this way. And from here to here. So, this entire thing is called as X-axis. Right? Now, this moves. These two are called as y-axis, right? So this is called as the right side of the y-axis, and this one is called as the left side of the y-axis. So these two rails are called as the y-axis, okay? And this one, this rail is called as the z-axis. If you move this pulley up and down, you can closely see that it moves up and down. These wheels here, these wheels and this maker slide constitute the Z axis. So this spindle moves up and down on this maker slide with the help of these wheels. So this is called as the Z axis. So these are the three axes in a CNC. So this is basically a three axis CNC or a router, you can say. So now once the X1 carve homes, it will home in the front here, and the Y axis will come to the front and the X axis will move to the left like this, and the Z axis will move on the top towards this end stop here. This plate will click with this lever and it will stop on the top. So this is how the entire machine homes. This is called as the homing of the X1 carve, right? It homes in the front left corner, right? So this is the homing. And once it starts carving from the home, the axis will move here wherever you have laid out the object in the software. And then this axis will also move. And then the Z axis will move downwards towards the surface of the cutting material. So this is just a very brief basic of the three axes of a CNC. Now if you look, this is the Y left stepper motor of the Y axis. If you see it from the front, this is the Y left, and this is the Y right of the stepper motor. Y right stepper motor. Right. This one is called as the Z axis stepper motor. If you see from the side, then this is the Z axis stepper motor. And if you see from the back, this is the X axis stepper motor. Right. If you remove this drag chain, this one is called as the X axis stepper motor. So the X axis moves with the help of this stepper motor. This Z axis moves with the help of this Z stepper motor. It moves up and down with the help of this Z stepper motor and with the help of this pulley and belt. Whereas the Y axis moves with the help of this stepper motor and with the help of this stepper motor. This one is the Y left from the front, and this is the Y right from the front. These are the pulleys which are mounted on the stepper motors. You can see that there is one pulley on the right, one on the left, then there is one on the Z axis stepper motor here, right? And then there is one on the Acme lead screw here, right? This is about the stepper motors. This is the spindle which you can see here. It is used for cutting the material, and this is the Z end stop. You can have a look at it. The Z end stop is mounted on the right hand side of the Z motor plate. There are two small holes in which these screws will go. So it should come on the right hand side if you see it from the front. And make sure that this lever is clicked by this plate. if this lever is not clicked by this plate, then once you home the Z axis, and if it is not clicked properly, then the motor will keep pushing upwards unless and until you shut down the power or this lever is clicked. So whenever you are mounting the Z axis end stop, make sure to press this end stop a bit forward, right, so that this lever is properly clicked by this plate. Otherwise it will result in a mishap, right? So this is the Z end stop. And if you talk about the Y end stop, this is the Y end stop. Here you can see this is the Y end stop, and when it comes